All right, everybody, welcome back. So, I'm going to do... Somebody had asked me a question what I would recommend, the SCAR SDR 12 or the Hayanka 12. I think it's a BSF 12. And honestly, between the two of them, I mean, we're going to do tests here, but... I would honestly, I'll just do the test and we'll see what does what. And I'll give you my conclusion at the end of the video. I'm not going to spoil that for you now. I'm going to let you guys watch. You guys can decide. You guys can choose and see which one does better. If you're curious about this box in particular is the one that everybody was making comments about. The box had, let me just pan over for a second here. The box had right here, the carpet was coming undone, and we E6000'd it, and it's perfectly fine now. The box sounds nice and clean and clear. It was making a disturbance. We did have that in the video, and we fixed it right away, and here she is. So let me adjust this again so we can get full excursion on this. There we go. All right. So without further ado, let's get into the demo here. And there we go. All right. Now, I don't think I would push it much more than it's being pushed right now. Let's see what it does. All right, so we're running around 1 to 2 ohms. So we have plenty of juice. We're running on the Taramps HD3000. And by the way, I'm doing the demo on both the same amp for the BSF and the SCAR Audio. They're going to be everything equal. I don't know about enclosure-wise. Hopefully I'm going to leave this in this enclosure, and I'll do the BSF in another enclosure. But other than that, I'm going to keep them on a pretty much equal playing ground. And from what I've heard is that the box isn't too small, but if in a smaller box, it'll take more power. So that's what I'm trying to accomplish here. Oh, stop 1400 watts there. 1433 on a burst. I'm gonna turn the amp up a teeny bit here. Let's see what we're peeking at here. Well, I'm seeing some serious power coming through. 1605, 1793. Let's see here. 1793. 2.2 ohms. So I guess the real test in the end would be which one actually is louder. You can look nice, you can take power, but are you louder? That's the question. So we'll have to really put them both to the test. I did a good job gluing this box down. I think I'm actually gonna buy carpet for my MTX box and carpet the box. See what kind of nice job I can do on that. All right, so we got 1.9 ohms, 1,904 watts, and this is a 600 RMS subwoofer, guys, by the way. 1,200 watts max. So we just smashed that RMS by 3. 1,904 watts we got on the dyno, nice and clean at 1.9 ohms. And by the way, this is a D2 sub wired to 1 ohm. All right, let's try something else real quick here. Oops, hold on. I don't know how it's going to come through, so I'm going to turn it down a bit. Got a quick commercial here, of course. We got to pay our dues for YouTube. Oh, bless me. Be right with you guys. Here we go. All right, let's see how it does on bursts. Now, sometimes we get bursts that are like, you see these crazy numbers. Sometimes they're realistic, sometimes they're not. All right, let's get her back on track here. All right, we're going to bump her up a little bit. $18.56, $19.80. No smells yet, nothing. Everything's coming through nice and clean. Which is nice because a lot of times when we use this amplifier, we have a lot of bursts that really don't make any sense on the come through on the SMD. We got 2.2 ohms, $19.80. I think that's actually our highest number yet. Still nice and clean. I'm not going to go much more louder than this. This is really where it's peaking at here. All right, so we got 2.2 ohms, $19.80. I'd say that's fantastic. All right, guys, so we're going to get the BSF going here. We're going to see what the BSF does. We'll be back. I hope you guys enjoy. Stay tuned. Don't go anywhere. All right, let me adjust that. Oops. Yeah, there we go. Oh, I'll move a little bit closer for you guys. Hopefully that's good. There we go. All right, so I'm basically going to do the same test with this. I actually did switch the box. It's in the same box because I don't want any test to be off or anything. I am going to include some other dyno tests as well when I first got this subwoofer, brand new out of the box. And from then to testing it now after it's been broken in a little bit. Yes, I said broken in. Because I have noticed that a lot of these subwoofers now, with the dual spiders and thicker tinsels and this and that, and just even your surround after it flexes a little bit, it does get worn in. All your parts in your subwoofer do get worn in. It's on the same amplifier, the Tar-Amps HD3000. It's also a D2, just like the SCAR was, so it's wired to 1 ohm, same box, same everything, so we're going to get on with the test. And as always, guys, thank you for watching. I appreciate you all watching. I do have one member so far. I got to check again. I haven't checked in a few days, but I did have one member, Carl. Thank you. Anybody else feel welcome to join anytime. I'll start making videos if you guys go to higher membership levels. I'll start making different videos for you guys, taking requests for specific videos for you guys. Let me know what you guys want. Let me know what you guys need. And I'll take care of you members indeed. You like that, huh? All right, let's get it on. Alright, let's see what we're hitting now. 1 to 2 ohms-ish. Alright. Give her another bump up. $1,100 I saw there on the camera. I do like this other camera I have because now I can see the dyno on the screen itself, on the side screen, and I can turn the camera also, the screen on the camera, so I can look at it in, from a different point of view. I think that's about maxed out. I really think that's about maxed out. I gotta say, in the house-wise, it does sound a little bit better than the SCAR did. Like, cleaner-wise.
Alright, let's see what we're getting for power here. Dyno power.
1813. Wow, that really hits hard. I just put my face up to the port and it felt like it blew my face back. It's hitting real hard. Wow. Looks nasty moving too. 1813 we got. Let's see if we can reset the dyno. All right. So we're gonna go back here. Over there. And go to that. We're probably gonna get a commercial here, so bear with me on the commercial wise. We'll be right with you. And guys, remember, if you haven't joined as a member yet, you're welcome to join with open arms. I'm gonna be having my third free subwoofer giveaway coming soon, so make sure you stay tuned for that. I'm giving you guys 10% back of what I earn from YouTube, so we're getting there. We're about a quarter of the way there right now. Possible. 2228. Now I saw 2228 nice and clean. Always on this test. Subwoofer, guys, no smells, no nothing. So they're actually pretty equal to each other in the same enclosure, same amplifier. I'd say the Hayanka is a little bit better. And honestly, guys, I believe the Hayanka has a 3-inch coil where the SCAR has a... Here, I'm going to shut this camera off here. So actually, you know what? I'm going to go get some information and I'll be right back and we'll share that information with you guys. And I'm going to have some other dyno tests as well from when I first got this speaker, and I'll be right back, guys. Stay tuned. Don't go nowhere.